Pete! Brock Lesnar lives by the motto, eat, sleep, suplex, repeat. Eat, sleep, F5, repeat. Eat, sleep, victimize, repeat. Eat, sleep, beat, repeat. Eat, sleep, conquer, John Cena.
Maybe the most dominant champion in WWE history. And Paul Heyman,
maybe the most hateable guy in WWE. I cannot stand to listen to Paul Heyman.
Very telling statement when he basically said careers die at the hands of Brock Lesnar. And John, the reason Heyman kept repeating suplex, 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 suplex is because last night in that match, Brock Lesnar delivered 16 suplexes to John Cena.
He was suplexing Cena like a rag doll. I've never seen anything like it, and he was right. Cena had a chance. He would not quit.
Well, I said it at the end of the match. You got to give the devil his due. Brock Lesnar was the conqueror last night.
Also at SummerSlam, Stephanie McMahon and Brie Bella. Stephanie picking up the victory after Nikki betrayed her sister Brie. We kicked off Monday Night Raw tonight with a confrontation between Brie and Nikki.
I can forgive you, Nikki. I can forgive you for all the
you
lies.
You can forgive me?
Yes. I just...
I will never forgive you!
And there you see poor Brie Bella, I mean, leaving the ring disgraced, slapped, and humiliated, and heartbroken.
All because of what happened at SummerSlam last night.
That slap was years from
the night. Also at SummerSlam last night, Seth Rollins, Mr. Money in the Bank, thought he finally got rid of Dean Ambrose. That is not the case after an Ambrose attack in the locker room area earlier tonight. There will be a rematch from SummerSlam, but it's up to you, the WWE fans, to decide on the WWE app what kind of match it's going
to
be.
That's right. Log on to the app or download the app right now. It's absolutely free, and you vote. Vote A if you'd like to see a no-holds-barred match. Vote B if you'd like to see a false count anywhere match, or vote C if you'd love to see a no disqualification match between Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose. Vote right now.
Also tonight on Monday Night Raw, huge six-man tag team matchup. Roman Reigns teams with the United States Champion Sheamus and Rob Van Dam against Randy Orton and Ryback. Six-man tag team action live tonight. The new Intercontinental Champion, Dolph Ziggler. He defends the title in a rematch from SummerSlam against The Miz. Championship match live next on Monday Night Raw.
You did this! You did this!
And we are back live on Monday Night Raw. The show off is the new Intercontinental Champion, Dolph Ziggler, winning last night at SummerSlam.
Big victory for Dolph.
Quiet on the set. Can we please have quiet on the set?
Wait a minute. Lights, camera, action.
Awesome!
I came to the game to play. There's a price to pay. Time for you to get down on your knees. I came to save the way.
And titleless. Ladies and gentlemen, you want to talk about this matchup on Twitter, we urge you to use the hashtag ICTitle. What on earth is the former champion wearing?
They had a moment of silence today on Rodeo Drive.
What is that?
Michael, it's designer clothing. Clothing, you'd never know that.
Who designed it? A monk? I mean,
you
come on.
You mock what you don't understand.
I mock, which is hideous.
You mock fashion.
He'll walk the red carpet with that on, won't he?
So this is for the Intercontinental title. The Miz losing the championship in Hollywood last night to Dolph Ziggler.
But he's still an A-lister.
The following contest, set for one fall, is for the Intercontinental Championship. Introducing first, the challenger from Hollywood, California, weighing 221 pounds, The Miz. And his opponent from Hollywood, Florida, weighing 213 pounds, he is the new Intercontinental Champion, Dolph Ziggler.
Had the opportunity to talk to Dolph Ziggler a little earlier today. He is so excited to be a two-time Intercontinental Champion. He understands the prestige that comes with that title. Over a dozen WWE Hall of Famers have held it. And Miz wants it back.
What class Miz has. Like James Dean coming down here in sunglasses, the lights on bright. That's a star.
Yeah, he's like James Dean. He's a rebel without a clue. James Dean.
Brad Pitt.
60 years ago? Brad Pitt's a little bit better, I guess.
Yeah, but James Dean is still an icon. Still to this day.
A nice shoulder tackle by The Miz. I heard they had to cancel a lot of parties last night in Hollywood Hills.
Parties were canceled everywhere.
Here's Ziggler, cover, hook of the leg, and a kick out.
Hotel Bel Air shut the bar at 10 o'clock. I'll tell you this, though, the parties are going to be rocking tonight in Vegas if Miz wins that Intercontinental Championship back.
Well, Dolph Ziggler's
they're going to be at Caesars, the Hard Rock. They're going to be all over the place throwing a party for the A-lister. It'd be like the Rat Pack is back in town.
Are you betting on The Miz since we're here in Vegas, JBL?
So which one would The Miz be in the Rat Pack?
I'm betting on everything I've got. Yes, absolutely. I'm going to double down on The Miz.
Double down on The Miz.
Dolph Ziggler, the show off, sent out an interesting tweet today when he said, congratulations, WWE Universe. You deserve the best as your Intercontinental Champion, and now you have it. Miz, cover, shoulders kick out by Ziggler.
Well, you heard Miz say he considers this a sequel. Except this one, he hopes to have a happier ending for himself.
The legs hurt, that's bad for Dolph Ziggler.
And John, remember last night we saw Ziggler tweak his left knee, and he looked like he tweaked it again here tonight. Oh, he landed on it.
Yep, hyperextended that knee. Looks like
Miz goes straight to it.
And Miz going right to work on the left leg. But again, John, go back to that match last night at SummerSlam. Dalton, I believe, tweaked the knee last night when he won the championship. We got more Raw coming up in a moment.
Like I say.
And this match is for the Intercontinental Championship. Dolph Ziggler, the champ in trouble, but he's got Miz here. Is this enough? And Miz manages to kick out at two. And Dolph Ziggler looking for a backslide. Shoulders down again. They have him here.
Wow, that was close.
Miz stays in it. Dolph Ziggler, the champion, really on one leg now in this matchup after tweaking his knee early on.
Whoa.
Ziggler, split out of the corner. DDT, is it enough for Ziggler? Can he capitalize?
He just retained his championship.
Leg hooked him, is it too?
Yeah, but look at Dolph's leg. It may have hurt Dolph as much or more than it did The Miz.
Yeah, Ziggler first injured that leg last night at SummerSlam. The injury furthered by Miz using the figure four leg lock last night. Ziggler tweaking it again tonight. Miz is taking control.
I think Miz knows that leg is his key to that Intercontinental Championship.
The Ziggler chance from the WWE Universe here tonight.
Uh-oh, caught.
And this was earlier on. We're going to show you how Ziggler got hurt. Now Miz going for the figure four leg lock. Top of
his computer
screen. He's got it locked in center of the ring. Ziggler taps out here. We got a new champion.
Nowhere for Ziggler to go. I told you, Miz is going to win this thing. I told you.
Look at the pressure Miz is putting on that leg.
And Dolph trying to claw his way out of this, but
you know the nature boy in the back of this. Look at him.
Figure four leg lock. What's Ziggler going to do here? Is Ziggler going to tap out? Ziggler trying to make it to the bottom rope here. Ziggler trying to make it to the bottom rope. Can he get there and force the break? The champion in trouble. The guy forces the break. Dolph Ziggler just making it to the corner as I see title is the number one trend in the world right now on Twitter.
And it should be because we're going to find a new champ.
Oh! But not if Ziggler can help it. Ziggler trying to battle through this match really on one leg here.
Yeah, Ziggler's really, really hurting here, guys.
Hey, I don't care. There's no way that Ziggler can defend this title on one leg.
Well, he's doing a pretty good job of it right now, John. Great move to Miz, and now Ziggler quickly back on the attack.
Yeah, Ziggler swept the leg out from under Miz, and I think Miz bounced the back of his head off that ring apron.
Oh, and both. Miz.
Both men down. Both
wait a minute.
Down.
Wait a minute. Look at the referee. Look at the referee. He's in a count of 10. He's in a count of 10.
The winner of this match as a result of a count out, The Miz.
Miz has just been screwed.
Well,
Dolph Ziggler got himself counted out on purpose because he knew he couldn't beat The Miz.
I didn't quite see it that
However,
way.
However, still Intercontinental Champion, Dolph Ziggler.
Well, Miz may have won the match, but remember, championship can only change hands via pinfall or submission.
Yeah, Dolph Ziggler knew that.
Boy, this is not going to sit well with The Miz. Oh, look out. Watch it.
Oh, look out. Now Miz outside the ring. Miz going right after the Intercontinental Champion.
Whoa.
And Ziggler driven right into the announce table. Now kidney first into the apron.
You know, I don't think Ziggler was even hurt.
Miz is livid.
I think Ziggler knew that he was overmatched tonight and he couldn't pull it off, so he fakes an injury and get himself counted out.
Come on, JBL.
Because he knew that he couldn't match up with an A-lister.
And Ziggler zigzagged to Miz.
I told you, Miz, Dolph was faking the whole time. I told you. Did I not tell you? Dolph Ziggler should be given an Academy Award for that performance. And he also should be given a championship.
Well, too bad championship doesn't change hands via countout.
Yeah, but you got to admit, this will probably keep Miz in the title hunt. He has a victory. It's an official victory over the Intercontinental Champion, Dolph Ziggler.
What a gutsy effort by Dolph Ziggler to
stay
in this match.
Wait a minute. Tell Dolph to stop faking. He's not hurt. You're not hurt. Match is over, Dolph. You don't have to keep faking that ridiculous injury.
Dolph Ziggler retains the Intercontinental title as we head back to the locker room area and our own Renee Young.
Please welcome my guest joining me now, Jack Swagger. Jack, let's take another look at your match from SummerSlam.
This was last night at SummerSlam. It was a flag match, and Jerry, it was one of national pride. Rusev had the accolade locked into Jack Swagger. Swagger refused to tap out.
He would not tap out, but he did, unfortunately, pass out.
And then we're going to show you exactly what Rusev did to Zeb Coulter when he came to Swagger's aid.
This is hard to watch. You know, it was at the urging of Lana. She gave the instruction, and Rusev carried it out, attacking poor Zeb Coulter.
Sickening.
Jack, you were in a flag match against Rusev, which, unfortunately, you lost. But how do you feel tonight?
Last night was the opportunity of a lifetime to defend the country I love. I failed. But you know what makes America the greatest country on earth? When things get hard, we come together. That's we the people. When the world's turned upside down and times are tough, we unite, we grow stronger. That's we the people. So I'm gonna do what every single real American would do when their back's against the wall. I'm not gonna give up. I'm gonna pick myself up and I'm gonna come out swinging because that's we the people.
Let's head back down to ringside.
Jerry, very proud man in Jack Swagger.
Well, you're right about that. I mean, he knew how much was at stake, and, it was just, he gave it everything he had.
As far as I'm concerned, he let me down. He let 318 million Americans down.
You'd rather be critical than correct.
This contest is set for one fall. Approaching the ring from Perry, Oklahoma, weighing 275 pounds, he is a real American, Jack Swagger.
Can Jack Swagger recover? Can he regroup? Swagger in action, live next on Monday Night Raw.
Where's Zeb?
And ladies and gentlemen, Night of Champions is presented by Diet Dew, the only diet with dew in it. We are back live on Monday Night Raw. It is Cesaro against his former ally, Jack Swagger. And guys, Swagger looking to regroup tonight after the loss to Rusev in the flag match at SummerSlam. Zeb Coulter not out here tonight with Jack Swagger after being kicked in the face after a disgusting display by Rusev.
Those ribs, oh man, right after they the certainly ribs. Aren't any better than they were last night. Probably a lot worse after what Rusev did.
Yeah, Rusev first injured the ribs a couple of weeks ago with an attack with a Russian flag. Re-injured the ribs last night, and Cesaro going right after him.
Swagger's not even close to 100%, it doesn't look like.
Cesaro, he's gonna stick and move, stick and move. Uh-oh, he got stuck.
Yeah, Jack Swagger, 270-pounder. Driving Cesaro in the corner, he needs to end this matchup early. Our allies.
Oh!
Rib first again, and Swagger looks all out of whack tonight.
Man. Wouldn't you be out of whack if you let your entire country down?
Well, he didn't do it. I mean, valiant effort. He didn't even tap out.
Sorry for Jack Swagger.
Here's Cesaro.
A chance to represent old glory, and he had a Russian flag waving over him.
He didn't give up. He didn't tap out.
Don't get me wrong. I hate Rusev, but I'm very disappointed in Jack Swagger. I certainly don't feel sorry for him.
Swagger, though, hey.
Before the match even started, Swagger wasn't even looking. Rusev attacked him, and Old Glory ends up on the ground. That's not supposed to happen. That's desecration of a flag, and that is all 100% Jack Swagger's fault.
Oh,
the entire
night
was a car wreck for our country.
You just said Swagger wasn't looking, and Rusev attacked him and from behind. So how is it Swagger's fault that the flag got knocked off?
Would you turn your back on an opponent, King? No. He should be on guard. He's representing the United States of America. It was a car wreck for our country last night.
This may be
one of our country's darkest moments.
This may be a car wreck for Swagger tonight. Cesaro, cover on Swagger, who continues to try to kick out, but he's hurt.
He's got a war hero kicked in the face. It should hurt.
You're telling me that was Swagger's fault as well?
All of this is Jack Swagger's fault.
Watch this one more time. Oh, all his weight. Cesaro lands right in the rib cage of Jack Swagger.
And yes, to answer your question, it's Jack Swagger's fault that Zeb got kicked in the face by that Russian.
John, listen, Jack Swagger said he failed.
Which is why he's not here.
He realizes that he believes he let the country down. You don't have to sit here and continue to rub his face in it.
Well, he should have his face rubbed in it. It was a flag match, Michael.
Oh,
it was symbolic of our entire country. Did Reagan blink against Gorbachev? No.
And Jack
did
Swagger.
Did Kennedy blink against Khrushchev?
Swagger bomb. Bad raise it all. Jack
that
Swagger.
Is dumb.
Swagger off the Swagger bomb. Is it enough to put Cesaro away? One, hooks the leg. Here, Cesaro powers out at two.
Why are you in such a foul mood tonight, JBL?
Because I wanted to see Old Glory waving, because I'm a patriot. That's why, King. And I'm let down by one thing, and that is Jack Swagger. Me and 318 million other Americans.
Actually, there's two at the table that didn't think Swagger let
him
down.
I don't think I'll ever forgive Jack Swagger.
I don't think he probably cares. Oh. And oh, Swagger dropped on the top rope on the bad ribs.
It's one thing to lose a match. You can even lose a match to a Russian, but you lose a flag match when you're representing the 50 stars and 13 bars?
As strongly as you felt, surely you confronted Jack today and told him your feelings face to face, I'm sure, right?
I stayed away from him. I can't stand the man.
Stay
I don't want to be in the same room. He stinks.
Lord.
My God.
You rant.
Look out. Uh-oh, look at Swagger.
Hey.
And Jack Swagger, Patriot lock now. On Cesaro. Swagger with a Patriot lock. Swagger trying to.
He's outside the ring.
Had broken before five.
You know, and if my memory serves me correctly, when Swagger had that Patriot lock last night on Rusev, JBL, you were very, very happy, very excited.
I was ecstatic.
Patriot
I was pulling for Swagger. Why do you think I'm so mad at him? He let me down. He let the entire country down.
So you're just a fair weather fan.
Oh,
a fair weather fan? I'm an American.
Uh-oh, look at
Patriot,
like a
neutralizer
by Cesaro. Less than 100% Swagger faces Cesaro.
Right.
The winner of this match, Cesaro.
I guess, David, you probably had your eyes shut when Cesaro poked Swagger in the eye to gain the advantage there.
It doesn't matter. Swagger deserves
it. Nothing matters, right?
Cesaro victorious over Jack Swagger here tonight.
Poor Seb.
Finally, a breath of fresh air. We need somebody inspirational.
$318 million. That's how many Americans that were let down at SummerSlam. When you lost that flag match to Rusev. And look at you now. Look at you now. Losing again. You've lost your manager, Zeb Coulter. You've lost all self-respect. You've lost your dignity. But you can get it all back. You can get it all back. You just have to.
I disagree. Jack Swagger couldn't get it back even if he did believe.
Well, we've been talking about
so
SummerSlam.
Disappointed.
Talking about SummerSlam throughout the night here tonight. What a great event it was. Last night on the WWE Network, including Chris Jericho versus Bray Wyatt.
Oh my gosh, we witnessed Bray Wyatt with that creepy, weird, exorcist-like spider crawl. And after that, there was a Sister Abigail performed into the retaining wall on Chris Jericho by Bray Wyatt, and then another into the ring, and that's what led to the victory for Bray Wyatt.
Right now, our own Renee Young is standing by with a very special interview.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my guest at this time, Y2J, Chris Jericho. Chris, after everything that you've been through with Bray Wyatt, how are you feeling now after suffering a loss to Bray at SummerSlam?
You know, Renee, I realized last night at SummerSlam that even after facing literally dozens of Hall of Famers here in the WWE, I've never faced anybody like Bray Wyatt. He acts like no other. He thinks like no other. He moves like no other. His upside-down spider walk is by far the most disturbing thing I've ever witnessed inside of a WWE ring. But I also noticed when I looked into his eyes, there was an emptiness there, an emptiness inside of him. He's got nothing. He cares about nothing. And when he told me in the ring last night during the match that he's already dead, it's because he's dead inside. And even though I lost to Bray Wyatt last night at SummerSlam after a tremendous match, I'm not dead inside. As a matter of fact, I have three things that Bray Wyatt will never have. I have the fire inside of me that burns to push me to be the best in the world at what I do. I have the fighting spirit that drives me forward every day of my life. And most importantly of all, by far, I have the best fans in WWE history. Yeah, that's right. I know that every Jericho-holic in this arena and watching at home right now will have my back no matter what I do. Chanting Y2J, Y2J, Y2J. Chanting Y2J no matter what I do, and that's something that Bray Wyatt and no other human being on this planet will never, ever take away from me, Renee.
Another excuse. I am sick of these excuses.
We're getting sick of you, JBL. Tell you what, we got some six-man tag team action. Randy Orton teaming with Ryb Axel to take on Sheamus, Rob Van Dam, and Roman Reigns. And ladies and gentlemen, that match is next.
And in tag team action tomorrow night, it's one-on-one. The world's largest athlete, The Big Show, versus Eric Rowan of the Wyatt family. Live on the WWE Network with WWE Main Event tomorrow night.
I hear voices in my head. They counsel me. They understand. They talk to me.
This is a six-man tag team match set for one fall. Approaching the ring from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing 245 pounds, he is the Viper, Randy Orton.
Well, JBL, let me hear you tell the world about how bad Randy Orton let you down. I know you're a big Orton fan.
Randy Orton wasn't representing his country.
Oh, come on.
Imagine Usain Bolt trips before he goes across the finish line and lets down Jamaica. That's letting down your country. That's what Swagger did. Randy should be proud of himself. Had a heck of a match last night with Roman Reigns.
He lost.
Six-man tag team match here tonight on Monday Night Raw.
He barely lost.
Orton teaming with Rybacksil tonight. And we want to show you what happened to Randy Orton last night at SummerSlam. He took on Roman Reigns in what we call the biggest match thus far in the singles career of Roman Reigns. And King, what a match it was.
It was an awesome match. I'm going to tell you, I'm not taking anything away from Randy Orton. He gave Reigns everything he could take. But look at that on the left side of your screen. A thunderous spear by Roman Reigns led to the victory.
Yeah, the biggest win of Roman Reigns' young career.
That's not about winning or losing one match. Look at Orton's career.
267 pounds is the United States champion.
Wait a minute.
It's not about winning.
You just said Chris Jericho was making excuses. He's a six-time world champion.
Randy Orton never made a mistake. Never had an excuse. Randy Orton didn't come out here and make excuses.
They didn't give him
Randy
time.
Orton just said like a man and walked in the ring, got ready for a fight.
It's not about winning or losing until you
From
lose.
From Bass Creek, Michigan, weighing 235 pounds, Rob Van Dam.
Were you up early in Vegas today or something? Have you been out of the strip already? What is wrong with you?
I love Vegas. I care about my country. What's wrong with you? And I care about winners and losers. And I care about no one making excuses. What's wrong with that? I'm a fan.
From Pensacola, Florida, weighing 265 pounds, Roman Reigns.
Are you looking to stand on the face of Randy Orton?
I'm a WWE fan. I'm an American. I'm a patriot. I'm proud of it. And what's wrong with you, Michael?